Welcome to a lesson on multiplying and dividing fractions on the TI-84 graphing calculator. Now the methods in this video are not shown to replace basic skills with fractions. However, it does give you the opportunity to check your own work or focus on problem solving. Let's first talk about multiplying fractions. We can enter these products directly into the calculator to get our answers. So let's get our calculators out. And on this calculator, there's not a fraction bar. So to enter in 4/25, we'll enter in 4 divided by 25, and for 5/8, we'll enter 5 divided by 8. But I also like to put parentheses around the fractions. So here's our open parenthesis, and then 4 divided by 25, close parenthesis, times, open parenthesis, 5 divided by 8, close parenthesis. And then we press enter, and this gives us the decimal value of this product. But if we want the answer expressed as a fraction, we can just press math, enter, enter, so the product is equal to 1/10. Now let's try the next one. We're going to have, in parentheses, 15 divided by 2 times, in parentheses, 3 divided by 5. We're going to press enter. It's going to give us the decimal value of this product, but if we want the answer as a fraction, again, we can press math, enter, enter, and notice we have an improper fraction. Let's go ahead and write that down. Now, if you're allowed to express your products as improper fractions, it's already in simplified form, but let's go ahead and review how we can rewrite this as a mixed number. We'll go back to the calculator. I'm going to take 9 and divide by 2. Even though we probably recognize this as 4.5, let's just say that we don't. The whole number of the mixed number would be 4, but we would still want to convert 0.5 to a fraction. Let's go ahead and subtract the 4. That's going to leave the 0.5, and now if we press math, enter, enter, it gives us the fraction for the decimal part. So 9/2 is the same as 4 1/2. Again, this one was probably pretty easy to recognize that 0.5 is equal to 1/2, but this will work for any mixed number. The last example for multiplication, we have 2 1/4 times 1 2/3. There's no special way to enter in a mixed number into the graphing calculator, so what we're going to do is enter in 2 1/4 for 2 1/4. So 2 + 1/4, close parenthesis, times, open parenthesis, 1 + 2/3 for 1 2/3. And this is why I like to always include fractions in parentheses, because whether it's in fraction form or a mixed number, it's always the same procedure. And now we can press enter. And then math, enter, enter, we'll convert this to a fraction, but notice it's improper. Let's go ahead and write that down. This gives us 15/4, and now let's convert this to a mixed number. So we'll type in 15 divided by 4. It's going to give us the decimal value that we had before. So 3 is the whole number part of the mixed number. Let's go ahead and subtract the 3, leaving the decimal part. And now we can just press math, enter, enter. So 15/4 is equal to 3 3/4. Now let's take a look at some division problems. They're going to be entered in almost the same way, except now we'll be using division. So for our first problem, we're going to have 5/8. So 5 divided by 8. And then divided by, in parentheses, 3 divided by 4. Press enter, and then to get the fraction value for this, we press math, enter, enter. So the result is 5/6. Let's take a look at 8/9 divided by 1/3. So we have 2.6 repeating. Let's press math, enter, enter. This will give us the improper fraction of 8/3. Let's go ahead and convert this to a mixed number. So we'll enter in 8 divided by 3 again to get the decimal value. 2 is the whole number. We'll subtract the 2 and then press math, enter, enter. So 8/3 is equal to 2 2/3. And we'll take a look at one more. We have 4 3/8 divided by 2 5/6. Let's go ahead and clear this. So remember, to enter in 4 3/8, we'll enter in 4 + 3/8 in parentheses, divided by, and in parentheses, 2 + 5/6. Press enter, and then math, enter, enter. We have another improper fraction, 105/68. Let's convert this to a mixed number. So we'll have 105 divided by 68. Press enter. Let's go ahead and subtract out the whole number part. So minus 1, and then math, enter, enter. So we have 1 37/68. I also have several videos that show how to do these types of problems by hand. So I think it's important that you know how to do them by hand, as well as how to check them on the graphing calculator. I hope you found this helpful.